Searching for that friend circle that we feel the most comfortable with. We search for that perfect blend of Robusta, Chicory and Arabica to get that good cup of coffee. And we are searching for that job that makes us jump out of bed, not hit the snooze alarm when we keep the alarm at 5 in the morning. And my life so far has been exactly that. It's been a series of searches. And during my icebreaker today, I will take you through a journey of me searching for an activity that soothes me, which makes me happy, makes me enjoy what I do. So ladies and gentlemen, my dear Toastmasters, my name is Harith and this is my first icebreaker speech, and I've joined the Toastmasters to take my public speaking to the next level. I was born in a remote village in Kerala, a typical village, a grove milking cows and planting trees and making coconuts for the family. And as soon as I was born, my parents wanted me to do everything, not just study. Put me to these classes, that class, this class, a truckload of stuff, right? And as far as I can remember, one of the first things I ever joined was karate classes, sometime during my lower school, right? And karate classes, we used to stay back after school for about half an hour. And the sensei, used to call him sensei, the master, he used to stand here and we had a group of students. And he used to teach us all kinds of punches and blocks and kicks and all sorts of stuff every day. And so this one time, he wanted to teach us the center block. He has taught us the center punch before and he wants to teach us the block. And he likes to pick one student among the students to demonstrate the whole process. And he picked me and he said, Harith, listen, I want to teach the other students here a center block. I want you to punch me and I will block it and I will show how it's done, right? And the 8-year-old boy in me had this monster inside me which kept saying, if Atal say something, do not listen. Do the exact opposite. So instead of doing the center punch, I used to do this. I used to do this. And I used to do this. And I'd be like, nah, 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 nah. Since I couldn't block my punches. Since I couldn't block my punches. This happened about 2-3 times and the sensei said, listen, I want you to do a middle punch. If you don't do it, I'll pick somebody else and do it. And I did that, I gave him a middle punch. He blocked my punch, came front, and gave a strong blow on my stomach. I was down. I couldn't even breathe for a while. And I was crying and all the other kids were laughing. And I went back home and I told my mom. So the karate classes is 8-year-old guys, kids getting punched in the stomach by 40-year-old black belt grade 3 teachers. I think I'll pass. And after that, I tried a whole lot of stuff. I tried basketball and then workout. I tried arts, which ended up me cutting the t-shirt of a guy who sat in front of me and getting suspended from school for a couple of days. That didn't work out. I tried singing. This is very interesting. One quick story. So in school, every class is given one chance to go up on stage and perform something. So this was in 8th grade, I was about 14, 15 years old. And the people who were supposed to perform weren't prepared. So last minute they said, Harith, you go, you know how to sing? You go sing something. And so I'm standing there in front of the stage. Principal, every single teacher in school, all the students, a truckload of people. I could have chosen some neat song, I could have chosen some ghazal, I could have chosen some bhajan. But of all the 10 billion zillion songs out there, I chose this one hip-hop song whose chorus goes like, I don't know if you've heard it, it's Rockstar by Nickelback, whose chorus goes like, I want to dress my ass with the latest fashion and get the front door key to the Playboy mansion. Like, look at the intensity of that. A 14-year-old kid announcing to the entire school, all he wants is the front door key to the Playboy mansion. And principal personally came to the class and said, don't ever let this boy go to assembly ever again. That worked out. After a while, tried a whole lot of other stuff, and eventually I picked up rhythms. I used to enjoy listening to rhythms a lot, rhythms and beats. I picked up percussion, and I started listening to a lot of music which I like a lot. And I started attending percussion classes on approval, drum lessons, all of that. And after a long time, I joined a lot of bands, did a lot of live performances, and here I am. So I'm not trying to say that I'm a really good percussionist. What I'm trying to say is I finally found something which makes me feel happy, which I can't even imagine my life without music, right? So since life is a constant series of searches, keep searching whatever it is you're searching for, and eventually you will have your calling. And when you do, all the previous time when you thought you wasted your time in sweat, when you finally have your calling, you'll realize it was worth every second and every drop of sweat. Thank you so much.